family is devastated after an e-scooter crash left their loved ones seriously hurt. Caitlin Jacobson suffered traumatic brain injury falling from a scooter after a Rockies game.
She is still in the hospital tonight, now learning how to walk and talk all over again. And tonight, her family is pushing the city of Boulder not to allow scooters on their streets.
And NBC7's Tom Mustin is live with the family's emotional plea. Tom?
And a lot of emotions tonight. In fact, the meeting is still going on here behind me. E-scooters were never actually discussed by council members today, but they did allow Caitlin's family to talk. And tonight, the family's message came through loud and clear. What happened to Caitlin can happen to anyone.
Caitlin suffered a traumatic brain injury, and she's been in the hospital ever since.
Powerful words from a grieving family.
I'm here tonight so that hopefully no other family has to go through this nightmare.
Jennifer Jacobson addressed the Boulder City Council Tuesday night, pleading with the city to continue its moratorium on e-scooters. In June, her sister Caitlin had been leaving a Rockies game at Coors Field on an e-scooter. She wasn't wearing a helmet.
The handlebars of the scooter were caught in a fence, and that flung her forward. And she didn't have time to react, and she fell directly on her face.
Caitlin spent 2 weeks in a coma, had several broken bones, and suffered a traumatic brain injury. This picture shows Caitlin's mother praying next to her daughter in the hospital.
She's 34 years old. She's relearning how to walk and talk and write and read. She has permanent brain damage.
Jennifer's brother, Jack, joined his sister at the podium. He's worried that college students on the hill in Boulder could be in danger on e-scooters, especially when alcohol is involved.
I don't have a vendetta against the scooters. I just really just want to raise awareness and let people know what could possibly happen.
After Caitlin's accident, the Rockies restricted e-scooters near Coors Field during ball games. Boulder has placed a moratorium on e-scooter business licenses until February. Jennifer says she believes e-scooters are simply too dangerous right now.
Our family doesn't want other families to have to go through what we had to go through in the middle of the night, waking my parents up at 3 o'clock in the morning.
Jennifer says Caitlin is slowly improving, and her family is hoping their prayers will be answered.
I can't wait for her to start climbing mountains with me again.
A tall wish for a devastated family.
Please consider voting against having electric scooters in Boulder, and please remember my sister when you make your decision. Thank you.
Now, that moratorium on e-scooters again ends here in Boulder in February. Council members say they'll meet again in February to discuss whether to extend or end that ban altogether. We're live in Boulder tonight. Tom Mustin, Denver 7.
Tom, thank you.